Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare, Hare Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Oh, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Oh, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Jai Om Vishnupada Paramahamsa Prajakacharya Ashtotra Shatashri Srimad. A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada ki jai. Jai Om Vishnupada Paramahamsa Prajakacharya Ashtotra Shatashri Srimad. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada ki jai. Ananta Koti Vaishnava Brinda ki jai. Namacharya Srila Haridas Thakur ki jai. Prem se koho Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda. Sri Advaita Gadadhar. Sri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda ki jai. Sri Sri Radha Krishna Gopa Gopinath Shyam Kund Radha Kund Giri Govardhan ki jai. Sri Vrindavan Dham ki jai. Sri Navadvip Mayapur Dham ki jai. Ganga Mai ki jai. Yamuna Mai ki jai. Bhakti Devi ki jai. Srimati Tulasi Maharani ki jai. All glories to the assembled devotees. All glories to the assembled devotees. All glories to the assembled devotees. All glories, all glories, all glories to Sri Guru and Sri Gauranga. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Hare Krishna. Today we are reading from the 11th canto, chapter 29, verses 7 to 9. We will be chanting verse 7. Shri Shuka Uvacha. Iti Udvenati Anurakta Chetasa Prishto Jagat Kridanaka Swashaktibi Grihita Murti Traya Ishvareshvaro Jagadasa Prema Manohara Smita. Shri Shuka Uvacha. Iti udvanyanati anurakta chetasa Prishto jagat kridanaka swashakti bhi Grihita murti traya ishvareshvaro Jagadasa prema manohara smita. Shri Shuka uvacha. Iti udvanati anurakta chetasa Prishto jagat kridanaka swashakti bhi Grihita murti traya ishvareshvaro जगाद स प्रेम मनोहर स्मित श्री शुक उवाच श्री सुखदेव गोस्वामी सेड इति दस उद्धवेन बाय उद्धव अति अनुरक्त एक्सट्रीमली अटैच्ड चेतस हूज हार्ट पृष्ट आस्ट जगत द यूनिवर्स क्रीडानका whose plaything, swa shakti bhi, by his own energies, grihita, who has assumed, murti, personal forms, traya, three, ishvara, of all controllers, ishvara, the supreme controller, jagada, he spoke, saprema, loving, manahara, attractive, smita, who smile. Translation. Shukdev Goswami said, thus questioned by the most affectionate Uddhav, Lord Krishna, the supreme controller of all controllers, who takes the entire universe as his plaything and assumes the three forms of Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva, began to reply, lovingly displaying his attractive smile. Text 8. श्री भगवान उवाच हन्तते कथयिष्यामि मम धर्मान् सुमंगलान् यान् श्रद्धया चरण मर्त्यो मृत्युं जयति दुर्जयम् द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉड हैड सेड यस आई शैल डिस्क्राइब टू यू द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ डिवोशन टू मी बाय एग्जीक्यूटिंग विच अ मॉर्टल ह्यूमन बीइंग विल कॉन्कर अनकॉन्करेबल डेथ टेक्स्ट 9 कुर्यात् सर्वाणि कर्माणि मदर्थं शनकै स्मरन् मयि अर्पित मनश्चित्तो मद्धर्मात्मा मनोरथि ऑलवेज रिमेंबरिंग मी वन शुड परफॉर्म ऑल हिज ड्यूटीज फॉर मी विदाउट बिकमिंग इम्पेच्युअस विद माइंड एंड इंटेलिजेंस ऑफर टू मी वन शुड फिक्स हिज माइंड इन अट्रैक्शन टू माई डिवोशनल सर्विस पर्पट The words mad dharmatma manorathi means that all of one's love and affection should be devoted to pleasing the Supreme Personality of Godhead. It is not indicated here that one should try to relish selfish satisfaction in devotional service, but rather that one should be attracted to the Lord's own satisfaction which one achieves by faithfully executing the order of a bona fide spiritual master coming in disciplic succession from Lord Krishna himself. Attachment to one's own satisfaction, even within devotional service, is materialistic, whereas attachment to the satisfaction of the Lord is pure spiritual emotion. ओम अज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनाशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपा कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकम्। वन्देहं श्रीगुरु श्रीयुतापदकमलं श्रीगुरुन् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपां सागरजातां सहगणा रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं सावधूतं परिजनासहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधा कृष्णपादान् सहगणा ललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च। हे कृष्णा करुणा सिन्धु दीनबन्धु जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधाकांत नमोस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानो सुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये। वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां भावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। नमाम विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सरस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्णा। सीकिंग ब्लेसिंग्स फ्रॉम ऑल द डिवोटीज टू ट्राई टू ग्लोरीफाई द लॉर्ड एंड द लॉर्ड्स होली नेम्स। So I would like to start off by saying that in any relationship, consistency is very important. Consistency as to the expectations of the person. If the person you are trying to have a relationship with is constantly changing the goalpost, so to speak, in terms of their expectations from you, in terms of the expectations for the relationship, it becomes very difficult to deal with such a person. And whereas if you see a person who's consistent, more or less consistent in his behavior and his expectations, it's easy to deal with such a person. So we see here, even the Supreme Personality of Godhead, whatever he said many years ago on the battlefield of Kurukshetra, he's saying almost the same thing here to Uddhav, in the Uddhav Gita. For example, if we check chapter 8 of the Bhagavad Gita, Tasmat Sarveshu Kaleshu Mam Anusmara Yudhyacha. He's telling Arjun that you should do your duty, but at the same time, internally, your meditation should always be on me. Similarly, the two famous verses, it comes in the 9th chapter and 18th chapter again. Man Mana Bhava Mad Bhakto Mad Yaji Mam Namaskuru. That always think of me, become my devotee, offer obeisances to me. Again, he's saying that if you want to perfect your life, you have to meditate on me, always remember me. And similarly, we see even the scriptures, it is said, this famous verse from Padma Puran, which says, Smartavya Satatam Vishnur Vismartavya Na Jatuchit Sarve Vidhi Nisheda Syur Etayor Eva Kinkara. That all the rules and regulations of the scriptures are servants of these two basic principles. Always remember Krishna and never forget Krishna. Therefore, Srila Prabhupada, taking it a bit further, said that this remembrance of Krishna is such an essential thing, and the easiest way, if you find, you'll find many, many purports in which Srila Prabhupada says that the easiest way of remembering Krishna in this age of quarrel is by chanting Hare Krishna. That is the most easiest and feasible way of remembering Krishna. And especially this Yuga Dharma Harinam Sankirtan, it is considered to be the king of all devotional services, devotional practices. In fact, it is mentioned by Acharyas and the scriptures that any devotional practice that we do, which is devoid of the chanting of the holy names, is not complete in this age. I was doing some research from the Hari Bhakti Vilas, just took one aspect about deity worship. And I was very surprised, amazed, and joyful to note that Sanatana Goswami, over 500 years ago, he clearly says that the chanting of the holy names is the life and soul of deity worship. Very interesting. Life and soul of deity worship. And for our deity worship to bear fruits, it has to be accompanied by the chanting of the holy names, the congregational chanting of the holy names. Otherwise, without that, the deity worship will not offer fruits. In fact, it is said from the time of the awakening of the Lord till the time the Lord is put to rest and offered flowers, all the procedures should be accompanied by the chanting of the holy names. In fact, it is mentioned that the chanting of the holy names is an unavoidable necessity in deity worship. Another extraordinary statement that Sanatana Goswami makes is that in this age, Harinam Sankirtan is the only way to install deities. It's a very revolutionary and profound statement. There's a very sweet pastime about this from an incident in His Grace Ayendra Prabhu's life. There was a devotee who was very close to him, staying in Delhi. This happened many years ago. And he had a desire to have deities in his house and worship them. So he approached Prabhuji and asked him, Prabhuji, can you come to Delhi? Because we know Ayendra Prabhu used to stay in Vrindavan. Can you come to Delhi and install the deities? So Ayendra Prabhu said, I'm not leaving Vrindavan. You get your deities and come to Vrindavan. Gaur-Netha deities. So the devotee got a car, vehicle, came to Vrindavan with his deities, informed Ayendra Prabhu. Ayendra Prabhu deities have come. But he noticed that no arrangements have been made. You have that Abhishek Patra and so many things have to be done. So of course, he was feeling a little, how can you ask such a senior person, please, please, how can you be after him? But finally, he gathered courage and said, Prabhuji, we have to install our deities. You had agreed. So he said, yes, yes, I remember. Do one thing. You get the deities to the temple hall. We are going to have the 24-hour kirtan. You come down. Get your deities to the temple hall. And then that devotee got Gaur-Netha deities to the temple hall. And Ayendra Prabhu did kirtan. Almost 2.5 hours he did kirtan. And after the end of the kirtan, he told the devotee that now the deities have been installed. And then he showed that devotee the exact reference from Hari Bhakti Vilas, where Sanatana Goswami says that the deity is installed by Harinam Sankirtan. So that devotee was obviously a little taken aback. He didn't have that much faith. So Ayendra Prabhu, just looking at his reaction, told him, don't worry. You take the deities back, and in Delhi, you call the devotees, you call the brahmanas, you do all the procedures, you do all the abhishek. But you should understand that because we have done Harinam Sankirtan, the deities have appeared now. They are here now. They have accepted our seva. So what to speak about? This was just one aspect I decided to research for the class. So if we get into different devotional practices, I'm sure we'll find a lot of similar qualities or similar stories which tells us the importance of the holy names, how the practices are incomplete without the chanting of the holy names. Therefore, by this, what we should understand is that we should understand that our relationship with the holy name is of extreme paramount importance. something which we cannot neglect. Other things may be going well in our life, may not be going well in our life, but this is something that we should give attention to, our relationship with the holy names. It's very, very important. Let's talk about ruchi for some time, the taste in the holy names. Like, for example, if you have two boys who's practicing to get into the cricket team, 14-year-old boys, and one boy is, the only practice he wants to do is at 5 o'clock, he reluctantly leaves his house, and then he goes in his gully or his street or his building, and few boys are there, similarly, not so serious about cricket, but he just wants to have a good time. And after 1 hour, and that too, the time he's there, he's fully distracted. And after 1 hour, he says, okay, enough, I'm tired now, let me have some soft drink, let me go home, let me watch YouTube or whatever. And there's another devotee, another boy. He's not yet become a devotee. So another boy, 14-year-old boy, same age. And he, exactly at 6 o'clock, you will find him all padded up, bat and the uniform, and he's at Shivaji Park. 6 a.m. dot. You can set your clock to his entry in Shivaji Park. And he remains there till 1 in the afternoon. 6 to 1, that's how much? 7 hours. Every day he does that. That is the kind of dedication he shows to get into the cricket team. That is the kind of dedication he shows to practice. Obviously, he's not sitting idle there. He's not sleeping on the ground. He's practicing his shots. He's practicing his different techniques, his different skills. Who will get into the team? Who has better chance of getting into the team? Now, one may actually argue that, Prabhuji, it is all the causeless mercy of the selection committee, you know? Yeah, I accept that, no doubt. But who is trying hard to get the causeless mercy of the selection committee? Without having that dedication, we cannot expect any kind of result. In fact, one of my friends in the ashram, he told me a very nice thing. Ruchi is just like an interest. If you put a fixed deposit, you get a certain interest. Let's say you get 10% interest. So if you put 500 crores in your FD, you get how much? 50 crores as your interest. And if you put 5,000 rupees, you will get 500 rupees as interest. So how much, it all depends on how much are we, in one sense, I'm not saying on an absolute level, one angle we should look at if you're not feeling the lack of taste in our life, how much are we really pursuing that taste? How much is the capital we are willing to invest? Without investing, how can we expect? It is foolishness to expect that we will get any taste, because if you have not invested anything in the first place. In fact, many people, by focusing on the chanting of the holy names, have perfected their lives. There are one or two nice, beautiful stories I want to share with you. Somebody I know in the dham, there's a story pertaining to his spiritual master's spiritual master. That is my friend's Param Guru. This happened many years ago, about 70, 80 years ago. So he was in the dham and he was a young sadhu at that time. And he had approached one of the bhandaras. There are bhandaras in the dham who distribute food to the sadhus, free food. So he approached one of the bhandaras, he got his prasadam and he was having. And then he saw that one beggar, torn, tattered clothes, must not have smelling, must not have taken bath for many, many days, dirty looking, and he tried to approach the counter of the bhandara for the prasad. And somehow or the other, he got shooed away. They said, no, this is not for beggars, this is only for sadhus. This arrangement is only for sadhus. Please go away. So somehow or the other, this sadhu saw him and felt a little compassion in his heart and said, please come. They have offered me too much prasadam. I can share this with you. So maybe he was hungry for many days. He very, very gratefully accepted it, had the prasadam. that beggar and washed his hand, washed his mouth. And by leaving, this beggar came to the sadhu and said, I thank you for the prasad that you have given me. I want to show you something. And then he took the sadhu's head and said, place your ear on my chest. The beggar told the sadhu, place your ear on my chest. And the sadhu could clearly hear from inside, Ram, 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 Ram. Then he took his head and said, place your ear on my arm. Ram, Ram, Ram. Place your ear on my belly. Ram, Ram, Ram. Place your ear on my leg. Ram, Ram, Ram. Then this beggar lifted that sadhu and said, he said in the local language, I'll say the local language only, Bahut sare siddh purush ghoom rahe hain is prithvi par, kabhi ghamand mat karna. Many, many perfected beings are walking on this planet. Never ever feel proud. And he walked away. And why go to many far away place? Actually, our grand uncle, Akinchan Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj, this is recorded in Gaudiya Vaishnav history. This happened during our lifetimes because Akinchan Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj left after Prabhupada left. It is mentioned that at the time that he was leaving his body, the Kaviraj or the doctor, when he put his stethoscope, they were able to clearly hear, very clear, the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra from inside. And there are witnesses to it, not just a doctor. The doctor was, he was sure that people would accuse him of making it up, so he gave it to others who were standing there, and they all heard the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra coming from within. So the point I'm trying to stress is, if we pursue something with that kind of intensity, we will get somewhere. If you are not trying to pursue at all, then we will not get anywhere. It's one thing to say, I want ruchi, Prabhu, pray for me, I want taste in the holy name. Oh, pray to the deities, you're going to the dham, you are in the temple. But this is the Bhagavatam class. Let's take a mirror and let's look at ourselves in the mirror. Not just the physical, let's look at our consciousness. Okay, this is a question for all of us. There's no need to answer publicly. But let's say the holy name appears. Krishna is non-different from the holy name. Krishna appears. And let's say, Krishna says that, my dear child, I'm willing to give you taste next moment. 100%, whatever you say, taste, ruchi, whatever, I'll give you. But what I want in return is, you have to sacrifice the association of the person you love the most in this world. You'll never be able to talk to him. You'll never be able to see him. You'll have to sacrifice his association completely. Or anything that you're attached to in this world, any prized possession you have to give it up. You can never use it. You can never see it. Are we ready for that? Suppose Krishna says, I'm willing to give you taste. 100% you want taste. You've been begging for it. Okay, I'll give you taste. But what you have to do is, give up the current position that you are in right now. The position, the prestige, the popularity, just give it up now. You give it up now, I guarantee I'll give you taste. Are we actually ready for it? It's something to really, really contemplate on. Let's say Krishna says, I'm willing to give you taste, but in return for this, you will be misunderstood by all your friends and everybody on the planet for the rest of your life. You'll be insulted, you'll be humiliated, but I'll give you extraordinary taste. The moment you chant Hare Krishna, I will appear in front of you and dance on your tongue. But you will have to face a lifetime of misunderstanding from others. Are we ready for that? It's a very, very, something that we all have to see where we are standing actually. It's easy to say, I want taste. But we have to pay the price. There's nothing free. There are no free lunches in this world. Let's become realistic. And just like this nice story, famous story about this guru, the disciple was insisting, I want Krishna, I want spiritual life, bless me, bless me. So the guru takes him to the river, we all know this, and dunks the disciple in the river. And then the disciple is just about to become unconscious because of lack of air, and then the guru leaves him. And the disciple is like, Guru Maharaj, what are we trying to do? I just wanted Krishna. I mean, you know, why are you doing this? So the Guru Maharaj, you know, his guru said that when you are as desperate for Krishna as you were for that breath of air, that means you're ready for spiritual life. Are we really, really that desperate for Krishna? But having said this, it might sound very depressing actually. Ruchi seems to be a very, very tall order. But yet, all hope is not lost. Right? There is something that can be done about it. At this platform that we are there right now, there is something we can do about it. And we can really get, feel and experience immediate effects. And rest of the class, I'm going to focus on that. What can we do about it? So we have to understand one thing about love and affection is that love and possessiveness go hand in hand. If you love someone, if you have affection for someone, it is but natural you feel a little possessive about that person. On the contrary, if you're feeling possessive about someone, it's probably there might be some affection or love. 100%, not probably. There is affection or love. For example, I may say that, you know, all brahmacharis are my friends, but my kirtan partner, Swarup Damodar Anand Prabhu. So when I say my, he becomes like a special because, oh, he's mine. Or let's say my room partner, Radhika Vallabh Prabhu. All brahmacharis are, but when I put the mine, there is some, like a little more intimate closeness. In fact, if you see the other way, it is seen that when the relationship sours off, that feeling of possessiveness is also gone. Let's say someone is having an extramarital affair, he feels more possessive about the other woman rather than his own wife. Something, just to drive the point home about possessiveness. So similarly, what we just have to do to improve the quality of our spiritual life is to feel that Gopinathji is mine. Bas. We have to feel possessive about Radha Gopinathji. Technical word for this is mamata. There is a very interesting reference from Chaitanya Charitamrita Adilila where Mahaprabhu is talking about the external reasons why he appeared, and he says yuga dharma pravartaimu nama sankirtan chari bhava bhakti diya nachamu bhuvan. I have come here to propagate the congregational chanting of the holy names, and I am going to offer 4 rasas to the world. Interesting. Chari bhava. We all know there are 5 bhavas, right? Shanta, Dasya, Vatsalya, Sakya, Vatsalya and Madhurya. So why is Mahaprabhu saying only chari bhava? So there are verses, we are not getting into that discussion, but once you read the verses ahead of this, we will find that Mahaprabhu does not count Shantaras as a bhav worth giving to the living entities. Because Shantaras is a bhav which is devoid of mamata, possessiveness of the Lord. And every other bhav that is there, Dasya, then Sakya, Vatsalya and Madhurya, that feeling of possessiveness for the Lord goes on increasing. Therefore, this feeling of possessiveness is such a important aspect. We have to understand that this Gopinathji, we have to have that bhav that this Gopinathji is my personal Gopinath ji. It is not just my counselors Gopinath ji or my friends Gopinath ji. This Gopinath ji who's on the altar, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, is my personal Lord, who's eagerly awaiting to taste my individual offering to the Lord. That is how that possessive feeling comes. And we have to also understand philosophically that he is missing our love. Just imagine this extraordinary philosophy of our Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradaya. Here is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the complete whole. We say that all things incomplete, when we add Krishna, becomes complete. As an example, we say everything else is zero, but we add Krishna, you add that one, becomes complete, right? But that supreme complete is feeling incomplete if even one insignificant jiva is not reciprocating with him in love. And what is the proof for that? He is sitting in Golok, he is having all his fun, and yet he, just to reclaim these conditioned souls who are not willing to accept his love and reciprocate with his love, he is willing to send away his nitya parshadas to the material world. Can you imagine, will you ever, somebody has been for decades, has been ruthlessly maligning you, blaspheming you, betraying you, will you send your best friend to him for many years and say that, just go and get him back here? You'll say, forget it. We'll all say, forget it, who cares? But Krishna, because he won't do that, because he's actually missing that love from that individual soul. Another reference about Gopinath ji being my personal Gopinath ji is just like in the Ras Leela, there was one Krishna who was dancing with all the gopis, but the gopis mamatva or possessiveness was so strong that it forced Krishna to expand into many, many forms, and every gopi was feeling that Gopinath ji is dancing only with me. Gopinath ji is caring only for me. This is such a, I'll just try to develop this aspect more and more, but this is one of the most fundamental principles of our spiritual life. If we are not feeling possessive about the Lord, it's very difficult to kind of continue in spiritual life. And let's for a moment analyze where is our affection right now? Because as a soul, we have affection. There is no option. But right now, our possessiveness, our mamatva, our affection is all on temporary things, temporary people, of people of this world, things of this world. Just like I remember Vrachandra Prabhu a few weeks ago, he was giving class. He said, every relationship in this world has an expiry date. No matter what you do, no matter how nice you are, no matter how everything, how many books you read about relationship management, this management, everything, you can't do anything about it. Either the relationship breaks in this lifetime or death is definitely going to separate you. Then what is the point of giving affection for such things? And what to speak about things of this world? That is also going to be ruined. So this is where we make a mistake. As jiva, as spirit souls, our propensity to give affection and be possessive, we are directing it towards the wrong place. But let's analyze, on the contrary, Krishna's affection for the soul. We were having a discussion and we just came out of the churning of the discussion, this point came out that there is one thing that is impossible for the Supreme Personality of Godhead to do. One thing. And what is that? Krishna can never stop loving a jiva. That software is not there in Krishna at all. No matter what he does, no matter how sinful his reaction, no matter how much he deserves to be in hell for millions and millions of years, but Krishna can never ever stop loving that jiva. I'll give an analogy. Let's say there is a group of devotees, group of people, villagers in the village, they are just kind of gossiping and they are saying to each other, hey, have you heard? In the neighboring village, there was one boy, he went to Mumbai and he got into bad association. And because of bad association, he started stealing money, got into drugs, womanizing, so many bad habits. And then he got into trouble with the police. And then he was in jail for 2-3 months. They beat him up properly. And now he's back. And they're like, oh, really? Oh, acha. And then someone says, shh, Ari, don't discuss this right here. Why? What happened? Ari, that boy's father is sitting there only. And then everybody turns to look at the boy's father. Please be with me in this analogy, okay? So the boy's father is sitting with his head in his hand, obviously going through different kinds of emotions, anger, disappointment, frustration. Why is this? Why did he do this? So many things are there. But the important point I want to bring out here in this analogy is, it is impossible for the father to deny that this is my son. That connection has been established. He is my son. So no matter how wayward the son is, how many wrong things the son is involved in, the father is helpless. He can never cut that connection from the son. He cannot deny that he is no longer my son. He is my son. So similarly, Krishna, in one sense, is kind of trapped. We jivas are all part and parcel of Krishna, and no matter what, he cannot deny that connection at all. It is we who denied that connection. It is we who are looking away. But as far as Gopinath is concerned, he is not saying, oh, this is a senior devotee, this devotee is doing japa, oh, this is nice devotee, these are karmis, this is that community, this community. From Krishna's point of view, everybody is intimately connected with him. And in one sense, and Krishna can do anything to reclaim even one soul. There is a reference in the Chaitanya Charitamrita where when Vasudev Datta prays to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that please deliver the all the entities of this world and give me their sinful reactions. So very interestingly, Mahaprabhu says that the universe is just like a bag full of mustard seeds. If one mustard seed is missing from that, what is the loss? You don't have to take the sinful reactions. I will deliver the whole universe just like that. The Lord will deliver. So for Krishna, one living entity is such a important person, he can actually deliver the whole universe for that living entity. In fact, if you just try to analyze, in one sense, in one aspect, of course, God has multifarious aspects, but in one aspect, the Lord is a real simpleton. Just like we say, if somebody is very simple, simpleton, what do we call him? Bholu Ram, right? Oh, ye to Bholu Ram hai. You know, so anybody can kind of cheat him. So in one sense, I'm going to develop on this. The Lord is very simple. Why is the Lord so simple? Because all he wants is love. Wherever he gets love, he clearly says, there is no hiding, it's an open secret. If you give me with love, I'll accept it. All I want is from you is your love. For example, just imagine, Ramchandraji, Ravan has kidnapped his wife and Ram has got report from Hanuman that Ravan is daily torturing Sita Mata in that garden. And yet, Ram says that if Ravan comes and takes shelter and he tells only once that, Lord Ram, I am yours, I will give him my full shelter. In fact, let's bring this particular aspect of the Lord's simplicity a bit more closer to our practical life. All devotees, all of us, sometime or the other in our devotional career, have felt really helpless and really hopeless and really begged to the Lord for mercy, prayed to the Lord for mercy, saying, Lord, I'm really helpless. I've done so many things in my life, but now I just wish to surrender to you. Please help me. Please get me out of this. And somehow or the other, by the Lord's causeless mercy, some arrangement happens and we are kind of out of the situation. But note, after a few weeks, after a few months' time, we kind of get back into our old habits. We forget whatever has happened. And then again, there is some push by Maya. Maya puts a gun on our head and then we are suddenly, oh my God, there's a gun now. Now I have to surrender. Again, we tell the Lord, Lord, I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Please, please save me. Please save me. And again, the Lord appears somehow or the other through devotees, through some scriptures or some situation changes. And the Lord extricates us from that situation also. If you actually closely see our lives, this is our situation. We pray and then we, you know, fall back again to our old habits. And then we again pray. Again, then we lift up. But every time we pray to the Lord, saying, my Lord, I want to surrender. I'm really, please bless me. Give me your mercy. Krishna takes us seriously every time. Let's say, Rasik Raman Prabhu, I take money from you and say, and you ask me for money. And then every time I tell you, Prabhu, deta hu na, deta hu. Sorry, galti ho gaya, sorry. 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, you will say, okay, mistake, I'm forgiving you. But after some time, you'll be, Sarbuj, I know how he is. He talks all big things, but he doesn't fulfill his promises. I don't want anything to do with him. But Krishna can never do that. Our intimate, that connection with Krishna is so intimate, Krishna can never ever ignore the deep heartfelt calling of a jiva for mercy. No matter how many mistakes we make. This is very, very important for us to understand. Sometimes we feel Krishna has ignored us, or why is Krishna doing this to us? And but it is impossible for Krishna to ignore. How? Just say, my finger is cut. Is it impossible? It is completely impossible for me to ignore the cut on my finger. It's a part of my body. If the finger says, oh, this guy is not giving me any bandage, or no, it's not like that. It is impossible for us to ignore this cut on our small body part. Similarly, it is impossible for Krishna to ignore the suffering of the jiva. In fact, related to this, there's one very senior Vaishnava whose Krishna consciousness I deeply respect, told me a very sweet thing. He said that sometimes we are during our daily routine, household work or some seva or something that we are doing, job, suddenly out of the blue, without planning, we remember the Lord. Sometimes it happens, Lord's form comes in our mind, or the Lord's holy names, or some point about some katha comes, out of the blue, without any endeavor from our part. So he said, just imagine, jiva who's completely covered by the 3 modes of material nature, where from this thought is coming actually? The thought about the Lord's form, the Lord's holy name, or Lord's katha, it's all non-different from the Lord. Where from it's coming? It's jiva is not endeavoring. So the sweet thing he said was, whenever we remember the Lord, we should know for a fact that the Lord is remembering us at that time. When the Lord is remembering us, that is why we get the remembrance of the Lord in our heart. And therefore, he said, whenever this happens, immediately just stop your routine work. It's just like, suppose your spiritual master gives you a call. Will you continue to do whatever you're doing? You will just drop everything and yes, Gurudev. Similarly, when we get the thought of the Lord, he advised, just stop whatever you're doing and contemplate some time about and in gratitude. My Lord, you were remembering me. Thank you. Today my day is perfect. Thank you. Thank you so much. And you spend some time with the Lord, meditating on the Lord, deeply contemplating about the Lord. Actually, like for Krishna, for Gopinath, we are extremely precious. We are like a jewel. And by remembering the Lord, why is the Lord again and again telling in Bhagavad Gita, remember me, remember me. Bhagavatam also, remember me, remember me. Other scriptures, remember me. We have to understand it is because the Lord is feeling obliged when we remember him. We have to understand this. Let's change our perspective. He feels obliged. I will try to explain with an analogy. Suppose you are going in a train, you're going on a yatra. and there are full of devotees, all bogies full of devotees, and suddenly you realize that you can't find your initiated beads. And you start backtracking your movements. You say, oh, S12, I did kirtan in S12. S7, I had prasad. S4, I did katha. S1, I talk with friends. So the whole train, you'll have to run around. Where is my bead bag? Are bead bag? Kala bead bag tha, black bead bag. You saw Narasimha Dev photo, bead bag, initial beads. Maharaj, kya hua? Bead bag dega? Asking the TC here, there. And finally, let's say one beggar who's sweeping the train. He says, Maharaj, come here. You're searching for this? Oh my God, can you imagine? The thing that you felt has been lost, you've got it back. You'll probably hug and kiss him. Out of affection. You can understand that emotion. Similarly, Krishna feels he's lost us fully. We are not thinking about him. He's desperately doing his dance. But we are constantly, batao, kya hai? Batao. We don't want to look at Krishna at all. And somehow or the other, when that person is looking at Krishna, we can imagine how obliged and how grateful Krishna and Gopinath ji will be. You have come back to me. In fact, that is why preaching is such an essential thing, essential activity, because preaching means nothing but connecting the lost soul back to Krishna. Can we understand what is the implication of preaching? Krishna feels this person is gone away and another soul is helping to facilitate this soul's connection back to Krishna. How much Krishna's pleasure will increase and how much that gratitude will increase to that soul who brings that soul back to Krishna. Simply by our own connection, Krishna will be so pleased. What to speak about connecting someone else to Krishna? This is a very, very fundamental principle to understand how important it is to feel positive about the Lord. At every aspect, the Lord is extremely positive about me individually. Not just because I'm in the temple or I'm outside the temple or what sinful activities I've done, not done, all my track record, doesn't matter at all. Krishna is extremely positive about me. He's got mamta. Let's try to develop our mamta for the Lord. For example, there is a businessman. We see there are billionaires and conglomerates. They're running big, big businesses. And they have got MBAs and double MBAs and managers and many, many efficient people running the show for him. But we will always see that as far as the inheritance is concerned, no matter how incompetent the child is, somehow or the other, just because he is connected to that businessman, as we say, blood is thicker than water, all that inheritance comes to the child. So similarly, if we want to inherit the spiritual kingdom, just be assured in that realization that I am connected to Krishna and just maintain that connection and possessiveness with Krishna. And everything else will follow. But if we don't have that possessiveness and that connection to Krishna, we may be doing so many things. Oh, kirtan. Oh, Prabhuji is doing 4-5 hours kirtan. Prabhuji is doing so much prachar. Prabhuji is doing so much management. Everything is there. But if we don't have that, finally, that mamatva, then we may not reach where we are aspiring to reach. Whereas another person who's more or less not really pakka in other aspects of devotional life, chanting, trying very hard, but sleeping in japa, and not so efficient in management, and so many goof-ups he does. But in his heart of hearts, he's very secure in his knowledge that Krishna is mine, and I am Krishna's, bas, that's all I know. Then there is a very great possibility that he can achieve the ultimate goal of life, and Krishna will be more than happy to have him in his association. So that is why we see Krishna is again throughout the scriptures telling, please remember me, please remember me, please remember me. Because when we remember Krishna, our mamatva increases, possessiveness increases. And the easiest way of remembering Krishna as mentioned by our dearmost founder Acharya, who spread the holy names around the world, is by always chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Yuga Dharma Shri Harinam Sankirtana Ki Jai, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
Hare Krishna, there is an announcement. For the pleasure of the Lordship, Sri Sri Radha Gopinath Ji, Sri Lalita Devi, Sri Visakha Devi, Sri Gopal Ji, Sri Sri Nitai Gaur Chandra, Srila Prabhupada and all the Vaishnavas, today's Nitya Seva, which includes entire day's Bhoga, Aarti and flower offerings to the Lordships, and also entire day's Prasad for the devotees, is sponsored by His Grace Kesav Prabhuji and Her Grace Namamrit Mataji on the occasion of their son Rishabh's birthday. We would like